Hey, Mini Fash. It is the 13th of June, 2019. And yet another article here. We need to do a little talking about climate change and how our lawmakers are changing their minds. Their picture here they use from Mexico Beach in Florida, where Hurricane Michael literally devastated the place, okay? That's a whole nother story. But this article really resonated with me to put out a message that just came upon me as to what we're really seeing here. And it gives you a very good perception of the depths of evil that you're dealing with. And that it is, in fact, a spiritual war. And this is a war for your soul. It's for your mind and your soul. They want you to simply give over to it so that you die in your sin. That's all they care about, is to keep you from the saving grace and knowledge of Jesus Christ. That's the number one plan. And climate change is, in fact, probably one of, if not the main linchpin, if you will, in their new world control system, their new beast system, okay? This is Agenda 21, 2030, and okay? And I know I'm talking to a lot of people who know this stuff already, but some people just seemingly don't have a clue, okay? The people who are running these programs, you need to understand, they are Satan worshipers. They worship the god of this world. They believe that their accomplishments and their... They believe this, that they are going to ascend and become the gods of this world. That's just the way they are deceived. If you're not in Christ, if you don't have a sincere love for the truth, then you cannot know the truth unless you indwell his spirit. Okay? This is their plan, to bring the entire world under control through weather modification and environmental disruption. What if you control these elements right here, the essentials, people are going to follow the rules. If they don't, prison and death. Simple. That's their sustainable development. That's what that means. Complete control of your life and your death. Okay? The information for all this stuff, for weather modification, the aerosol spraying, all this stuff is still available, although they are trying to wipe it out. It's still there. Public information for those who want the truth. You need to understand this stuff. I'll link this here, this lecture, Bernard Eastland. He's like the father of HAARP. And that system has evolved into such a worldwide, precise, and powerful system. It's no longer HAARP. They just laugh when you say that now. It is now Skynet, if you will, and they use these particulates as a receiver, as a mechanism to move weather patterns, to move air flows. This is what they're doing, and they've been doing it for a long, long time, and it's destroying the ecosystems of the world. But they call it climate change and blame it on you. You understand? They create the problem. They garner the reaction from you because you're demanding a solution, and they come in with their preset solution, which is complete and utter control of your life. And there, it just saddens me there's so much discussion on climate change, and no one even seems to want to look up in the sky on any given day and witness with their own eyes what they've been doing. And it just blows your mind to think that they refuse to see this, and they refuse to see it for what it is, and they believe the lie, because it's more comfortable to them, because they don't love the truth. It really is that simple. Spiritual war, people, it's a lot more than you think. You need to understand it. You need the Spirit of Christ in order to navigate it, all right? So they're not all ignorant of this stuff. These Congress people that they're talking about here, not at all. They know exactly what's going on. And it's very sad, but it's very true. Okay? They are just either doing it out of fear, greed, pride of life, all the fleshly things. It's pathetic. It really is. because this chemtrailing, these geoengineering programs are literally the number one reason. Now, there are many factors, but this is the number one reason. You need to understand this. You just do. What do you think is going to happen when this is being done every single solitary day worldwide? What do you think is going to happen? What kind of an effect do you think it's going to have on ecosystems and weather systems? Exactly. It's the exact result that they were looking for, because they're insane. They will do anything to ascend above the clouds. You understand? And the people who believe it, even though it's thoroughly documented, are nothing less than the blind being led by the blind. It's just that simple. Millions of tons of nanoparticles sprayed into the atmosphere. Again, what did you think this would result in? It's pure evil. It's insanity. It's the agenda. While I was researching this, you need to see this. While I was researching this, they show Hurricane Michael here. So I was looking into Hurricane Michael and I came upon this from the Weather Channel. Okay? Now, get a load of this and wrap your mind around this. The Weather Channel, there's their little bitty logo there, is really known as the Weather Company. Now just let that roll around in your mind. The Weather Company. And it is a IBM business. Powered by the cloud. If you know what I mean. This is all right in front of us. The Weather Company. By IBM. Seriously. Think about this. They believe that they are the gods. We're talking about Babylon here, people. IBM, they're the company that created and developed the computer systems for the Third Reich to logistically, you know, develop methods to where they could eliminate millions of humans quickly and efficiently. And they did it. And their number tattoo system, all IBM, precursor to the 666, but through the weather modification, primarily the spraying the particulates, weather patterns have been disrupted. So much, for so long now, we have a radical, unpredictable weather pattern destroying ecosystems. And there's your problem. Displacing people, it's a problem. It's a big problem. So critically damaged, homes and lives are destroyed due to weather modification programs, which are done through covert operations and heavy-duty cover-up and propaganda. So, what do you think's going to happen? The public demands action. A reaction is achieved. So highly publicized, so-called activists and scientists and politicians, corporate and business leaders, appear to pressure lawmakers to take action. They, therefore, force the public into a level of serfdom through laws designed to save the world. Complete control. There's the solution. Your new world order. And again, this is just part of it, but it's a huge part. And these lawmakers, okay, these lawyers, they're hiding from the truth, or they're flat out lying by omission. And I made this little note here. People keep sending me links to this Mr. BB channel. And every time I look at one, all I see is chemtrails all over his videos, and he skates around them and avoids them and calls them other silly things. He is omitting what he's seeing. Do you understand? And he's making probably a good living doing it. I love these people. I'd want them to turn to Christ, but this man is a gatekeeper. I pray for him. Congress and the lawmakers, they are the lawyers. Check this out. This is who they are, okay? Let's start Luke 11:46. Woe unto you lawyers. You made laws, okay? You laid men with burdens grievous to be borne, and you yourselves touch not the burdens with one of your fingers. And that's just a fact. You see what I'm saying? They hinder those who would enter into the knowledge of Christ. This is a very serious offense. What are they doing right now? They're just laying in wait for us to speak truth so that they can find something that they can falsely accuse us of and shut us up. That's what's going on. Okay? They gotta eradicate the truth. It damages their agenda. They gotta get rid of it. This is a spiritual war, people, and this propaganda and mind control of theirs is a key component. They are right now carrying out an information holocaust, making good evil, making up down. It's just the way it is. We are in the end times. Only God through Jesus Christ, the Savior, can pull you and save you from this certain destination of hell. So I pray you know him. If you don't, you need to seek him humbly, sincerely, with a love of the truth, and he'll reveal himself to you. Open the Bible and ask for understanding. The weather company, the IBM cloud, get a load of this stuff. Time is short, folks. Seek Jesus. Peace and grace to you. Many fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,